Cause God's love can still be seen on your hands and on your feet. You feel your heart, all of grace. Let its grace open wide. You have raised us up to life. And we breathe again. It's ministry. We're in a place, the Lamb of God, He made a way. He was brought to die so I could live again. He was brought, He washed away our sin. His dreams of mercy. In the shadow of the cross, we see our shame for what it was, and feel your heart, your heart of grace. See your power breaking through, and all that we've become in you, we breathe again. It's mystery. From the grave, you're raised to life. The Lamb of God, we went to hide. And once for all, you died so I could live again. Once for all, you washed away our sin. Thank you.
You know, in our multicultural society, there's a you come in contact these days with names that are really challenging. And I remember I worked for a long time with this Armenian lady, and she had a tough one. Nobody would ever say her name because it was too hard to say. When I sat down that one day, I said, "No, I'm going to learn your name. I'm going to say your name the way it's meant to be said, because that is who you are. That identifies who you are, and that matters. Names matter. I named my children very intentionally, as the Spirit led me."
That's right.
And Jesus, or Yeshua's name, is important. It's a powerful name. There's no other name that compares to Yeshua. And we live in a world that either wants to cross him off or eliminate him or blot him out or come up with another name for him.
May it never be here.
People start talking about Muhammad, or people start talking about Allah, or people start talking about Jesus. Only Jesus in a different context, in a different way that he was intended to be. We've renamed Yeshua in our days. That's just unacceptable.
Oh, I see what you're saying.
There's something in the name Yeshua that we have to get right. We have to take the time to not only get the name right, but most importantly, to get the man behind the name right, the God behind the name. We've got to get this right. Our souls and the soul of this nation and this world depends upon. Wonderful name.
Yeah.
What a powerful name it is, the name of Yeshua. What a powerful name it is, the name of Yeshua.
It's interesting. I got a text from a good friend of mine this week that was, when I got it, I looked at it and I was kind of puzzled because it says, not important. Wow, that's kind of a strange text to get from a good friend. But then it was immediately followed by, I'm sorry, I sent it to the wrong person. So I texted back and I said, well, that's okay. I don't really feel that important. And his comment back to me was, but everybody is important in the eyes of our Father.
Amen.
And that's very true. I sat here this morning during worship trying to think, what on earth can I say at a time like this? Because it's been a tough week. And Robert will tell you it's been a really tough week.
Yes.
But it's tough also for the rest of us because Julia was a very important part of our congregation.
Amen.
She was life when there was lack of life in other areas.
Yes.
And yet she was one who would worship. I always could hear her during worship time back there just worshiping and praising.
Yes.
She could be just a, I'm sure. Thoughts and prayers are out to Bob at this time as he tries to rearrange a lifestyle.
Amen.
Because it's been the last probably year to 2 years, she has been the absolute center of all of his attention.
Yes.
And now all of a sudden, what do I do with the rest of my day? Because his day was pretty well planned. But rest assured that she is in great care at this point. And we thank our Father for allowing her to be a part of our congregation.
Thank you, Lord.
As we look to the fact that fall is falling on us, there are still things that need to be done to our building that we'd like to get done before winter really sets in. Incidentally, snow is predicted for the western part of our great state today. I just say that just to make everybody feel comfortable. My hometown got 6 inches of snow last night.
Oh my goodness.
I have to put something out. If you have, it may not mean a thing to any of you because you've never been there. Lake Superior last week on Tuesday experienced the worst storm that that they haven't recorded history. It actually is even a worse storm than what when the Edmund Fitzgerald sank. Everybody knows about Edmund Fitzgerald, that sank in Whitefish Bay. They recorded waves on Lake Superior greater than they've ever recorded before. You think of Lake Superior and consider a 29-foot wave.
Oh.
It was recorded at one of the buoys just matter of fact, they said just north of Trowbridge Park, which was a little community that I grew up in, which isn't anywhere near, well, not anywhere near the lake. Up there, if you're more than a mile from the lake, you're nowhere near the lake. But I'm just about 2 miles inland. But there is an area that we go to swim all the time, particularly when I was young. It's a sheer rock wall that goes down into the water, and everybody swims and jumps off that. It's about 15 to 20 feet off the water. But we were watching pictures of that yesterday that people had posted. Water was literally just washing right over the top of that big monstrous rock. But somebody made a comment that no one knows the fury of God until they see Lake Superior in a very severe storm. Our God is powerful, but you know, they posted a picture of that very same area just 48 hours later, and it was perfectly calm.
Yes.
Our God can turn a storm, a hellacious storm, into the beauty of a peaceful lake. Lake Superior is beautiful, especially when it's calm. But it's beautiful in its fury also, just to realize how powerful God really is, and that He is in control. I say that to say this, you can have the worst storm in your life, but there can be peace immediately following it. He can take that stormy storm, that horrible conditions, and turn them into perfect peace. That's to you, Bob. Peace will come. We would like to get the building, the exterior of the building painted, if at all possible, before weather descends upon us. And so if you can help with that, please let our folks know so that we can try to get that scheduled in. There are also some other repair work that needs to be done, should be done before winter. Hopefully we can get to those also. However, it all takes funding. For the last several months, I've complimented on the giving. This month, we are down considerably. So Dr. Box is up here. I would encourage you to help in any way that you possibly can to get that restored back up to where we were financially. We are entering into a time, we have come through an expensive season when you come through the fall feast and all that takes, trying to get the building prepped and all those type things. But I just make that